Unraid has recently added support for ZFS in their beta releases. So today I want to take a look at how ZFS and Unraid works, see how the interface is, and just see how the overall experience of using ZFS in Unraid is. This has been available for a few years now as a community plugin in Unraid, but now that it's natively built in, I want to see how the developers added ZFS support. So taking a look at my Unraid interface right here, I have Unraid version 6.12 release candidate 6, which is the beta that supports ZFS. The first thing I see under the main share is all of these disks that need to be set up to have drives on it. This is the normal way of setting up drives. So for example, I was going to add one of these 3 terabyte drives here. I can go select on this drive, and under file system type, I can say use ZFS, but it's going to use ZFS as a single drive here, and not really give you a lot of ZFS advantages, like having the ability to do RAID or caching or anything else. It's just going to use it as a drive, which Unraid uses their own storage system on top of. So I could do that. In order to use all the features of ZFS and Unraid, I'm going to have to go set up another pool. So I'm going to go under add pool, and then I'm going to call it like maybe ZFS data. And then I'm going to add more slots so I can add more drives to it, and I'm going to click add. And it says there's a trailing digit. So I'm just going to do data and add, and it looks like it's pretty picky with names, pretty much wanting only lowercase characters. But now that it's been created, I can see all of these unassigned ones here for my ZFS data pool. And in all of these, I can assign any of the drives that I'd like to it. So let's start out with something simple, like just a simple mirror of 2 drives. So I'm going to go assign 2 drives to the ZFS data pool. And then I can click on any of these drives here. And under that, I can go into file system type, ZFS. And I'm going to set it up as a mirror, 1 group of 2 devices. Let's turn on compression to on. Auto trim, doesn't matter because it's all mechanical hard drives. Sure, minimum free space, that all looks good. So I'm going to hit apply. And now I've set up this one, so I'm going to go back to my main tab. And I can see I have these 2 drives here set up with ZFS as a file system on this system. And if I want to, I can start the array. It's probably going to have to format a few drives to get it all ready for usage, which might take a minute or two. And now after the array has been started, it says unmountable, unsupported, or no file system. So I have to go under here and click format. And hopefully that's going to actually format all my drives to ZFS and make it usable, like it says it's going to do here. So now it looks like it is formatting, and in a second or two, it's going to be ready to use and set up a share. So I'm going to go create a share for this right now. So I'm going to go add share and just call it like ZFS test. And I'm going to say use it from ZFS data, no secondary storage, add share. And then I'm going to go mount that on my system so I can do a little bit of testing with performance and just copying data to it. And now my ZFS mirror has been created. I'm copying data to it on my share. If I alt-tab over to my system, I can see I'm copying at about 113 megabytes per second, which is about the max you'd expect out of a gigabit network. I also have the command line open on the system, so if I run zpool-iostat-v, I can see that it's made a mirror array right now, which is about exactly what I'd expect. It's copying at the speeds I'd want. And if I go zpool list, I can see, for example, it is the 2.72 kibibytes of data, exactly how I'd expect. And if we run some commands like zpool list-v and zpool status, that shows me a little bit of information about the array. It was made exactly how I would have wanted, which is a mirror of 2 drives. Now let's add some drives to this. ZFS supports adding drives hot to this array if I want, of different types. So I'm going to try doing that right now, and I'm going to click stop, because I need to stop the array for me to make any changes to all of these drives. Now, ZFS should actually support doing this hot with all of its ZFS internals, but it looks like Unraid was using a lot of how Unraid's file system works and doesn't let you do it hot. So I'm going to go add this RMS 200 drive, which is a DRAM SSD that I want to use as an S-log drive. So it says all devices will be overwritten when this is started, which is fine. I want it to get formatted. And under the usage, it says it doesn't give me any options if I select on this exact disk. So I'm going to just go to the top level ZFS data, which gives me all the ZFS control. And it doesn't seem to give me any options to make changes to anything. I can see all the drive info here, but if I want to see ZFS data, it's just this little bit right here. I can't change any of this since it's been created, it looks like. And it doesn't look like it really gives me an option for adding this drive as a log drive if I want. If I click on the top level array, it doesn't give me any options. If I click down here, it doesn't really give me anything ZFS related here at all. So I'm going to just go back and I'm just going to say start this array and see what it says. New device too small. Does it only allow me to add drives of the exact same size? So if I add another 3 terabyte drive, let's see what it does in this case. Maybe I can click on ZFS data, and this is still all grayed out, so I can't make any changes here. If I go click on the drive I just added, it doesn't give me any ZFS options here, it looks like. So I'm just going to hit start and see what it says now. And now that the array has been started, I can see that it shows the same size and usage and free data. It looks like it's reading data from these two drives and writing it to this drive in about the same total speed. Kind of interesting what exactly it's doing under the hood here. And it doesn't give me an option to format it, so it looks like it's already been formatted. So I'm pretty curious about what this drive is being used for. So I'm going to go open the terminal right now. So I'm going to run zpool status to see how this drive has been added. And it looks like it's adding it as a third drive into the mirror. So now it's a three-way mirror. So all three of these drives have the same data. And that drive usage is because it's re-slivering the drives. So if I run zpool io stat-v, I can see that it's reading drives from these two and writing it to this third one. So all the drives have identical data on them. So now I have three drives in a mirror, which I don't find to be super useful often, but is an extra safe way to have the data. But if I click on it, now it says one group of three devices. I still can't make any changes, and I can't do anything else. From everything I see in this current GUI, there's no way to add an additional device to the ZFS pool. So I couldn't add an additional mirror or anything else in the GUI at least. But perhaps I could do it in the command prompt. So let's say if I run like maybe lsblk to find out all the devices on the system, I see this NVMe 0 and 1 is my 8GB NVMe drive. So then I'm going to run zpool add ZFS data log and then /dev/NVMe0N1, which is my NVMe drive, and it should add it as a log drive. And it looks like I formatted it as NTFS in the past, so I'm going to use -f to override that. And it looks like it's formatting and thinking about adding it to the array. So in a second or two, it should be part of the zpool array. So if I was just to use Unraid as a file server using SMB, having a log device doesn't help at all because I'm not doing sync writes and the log device only helps if sync writes. But if I take a look at this pool in the interface right now, that drive doesn't show up. What it looks like it does is it takes these drives and adds it to the ZFS configuration and doesn't read back from ZFS configuration into this interface right here. The only way that Unraid seems to use the data that it pulls out of ZFS and shows it to you is right here, where it essentially runs that zpool status command and then prints it to the screen here. But it doesn't seem to be able to take this is now a log device, and show it on the screen. It just exists here. Now, one thing I'm curious about is because Unraid is kind of a read-only system and stores all of its data on a config file and then rereads it on boot up, I want to see how it does with this log device, because ZFS knows this log device exists. And there's metadata on this log drive that says it exists. I want to see how well it handles a reboot. So I'm going to go to this system right now and make it reboot and see how it handles that. So my Unraid system is finished rebooting right now, and I see all the same devices in the pool. And if I go to hit start right now, because I have auto start disabled, it should start it all back up and mount the ZFS array, and we'll see how that works. And after a reboot, ZFS has started right back up and sees exactly the same drives on the system. And if I start copying files to it, it copies files to it successfully. Now, one interesting thing I noticed when looking at zpool statuses is it's using like the SDA, SDB names on the system. And those are typically not recommended to be used because those can change between reboot and drive configurations, and then it'll get a bit confused that the drive's in a different spot. So I'm going to purposely mess with ZFS right now by shutting down the system, moving the drives around so they're plugged into different ports, so these drive letters are no longer the same, and see how well the system handles that. And I rebooted my Unraid system, so my configuration looks about the same now. But I've added another NVMe drive, so this is now NVMe 0 and 1, and my 8GB drive is NVMe 1 and 1. And it looks like I messed with some drive letters. So it looks like, yeah, B is now part of my ZFS pool, even though it wasn't previously. So let's start it out and see if it starts correctly now. And after clicking start the array, it doesn't seem happy. It says unmountable, unsupported or no file system. It says unmountable disks present. And you want to format it, otherwise there's going to be problems. So that does not look good. Out of curiosity, let's pull out the command prompt again and do zpool import. This should scan all of the drives in my system for drives that could potentially be on here. And it looks like I have SPED, which is from an earlier use of my drive, ignore that. And I have ZFS data that I used earlier. And ZFS recognizes these new drive numbers, but Unraid doesn't. And I don't want to format it, but if I do something like zpool import ZFS data, it should be able to bring all of these drives back here. So if I do zpool status, I can now see on my system, it has all these drives, it recognizes it, and it should be mounted again. So if I run df-h, I can see /mmt/ZFS data is now successfully mounted. And it looks like it's still not happy. If I refresh it again, it doesn't recognize that ZFS data is alive. And it thinks it's not mounted and can't be used. So it looks really unhappy if drives are moved. Another curiosity I have is by default, if I create a new pool, it sets the file system type to auto. What does auto mean? So in order to find out, let's go format it with it, set to auto. So I'm going to hit start and it should bring this new ZFS data B online. And now after starting the array again, it says it's online and it says file system is still auto and it's an unmountable or no file system. So let's click format and see what it formats this drive to. And it looks like if you format a drive as auto, it means it will format it to BTRFS. And since I have a BTRFS drive, I might as well take a look at what the BTRFS options are. It looks like I can change the file system type to something else. Strangely enough, I get a lot more options now than if I did when I didn't have it formatted as BTRFS. And I could turn compression on and off. But other than that, it doesn't look like I can change really any other BTRFS options. But I can also go back and create a different pool. So maybe I can call it like ZFS pool C, for example, put a couple more slots in this pool and click add and create another pool. So it is nice that I can have multiple ZFS or BTRFS pools on one system. Another thing I'd like to take a look at is how well Unraid ZFS implementation is when it comes to having drives that are added to a ZFS pool manually and having Unraid keeping you from accidentally overwriting those drives. So for example, I'm going to make a pool that is a mirror of two of those 100GB drives, and then I'm going to add a second set and see if I can accidentally format those drives or cause any issues or problems. Now one thing I would like to note is when you're creating the pool, there's a good amount of somewhat common options that are missing. So like compression is either on or off. They don't have options for like ZSTD or some of the other potentially better compression methods built into ZFS. You don't also have options for things like A-shift, which would often be nice to set in ZFS because it can help optimize performance. And now I want to turn my ZFS mirror into a ZFS set of striped mirrors, essentially turning a RAID 1 into a RAID 10. In order to do this in the command prompt, I'm going to do zpool add pool name, so ZFS pool C, mirror, and then my two devices. So I'm going to run that command right now, and in a second or two when this command runs, I'm going to run ZFS list-v, and I can see now I have two sets of mirrors in the pool. And that has also doubled my capacity. And if I go take a look at the ZFS pool C, it shows that that's what I have on this system. And then I'm going to go back, take a look, and it still says not present, and I should be able to still assign those drives. And now that I've added those drives to the pool afterwards, I want to see what happens if I accidentally add those to something else. So I'm going to add them to the main array right now and see if it complains or if it tries to format it or sees any issues when I start the array up again. So I'm just going to go here and click start the array and see what happens. And it now detects it as an unmountable file system. So it says it's unmountable, unsupported partition layout right now. So let's say I want to go and format these drives. Maybe I'm accidentally going to click format on these drives and see what happens. ZFS probably won't let you just do it, and it says unmountable no device. That's an interesting error that I would wish I would say already part of a pool or something like that, but luckily it hasn't broken it. So if I try to accidentally assign a device that I manually assigned to ZFS in the command prompt, Unraid will not format it for me and will likely complain that there's issues formatting it. Now I want to take a look at running ZFS scrubs in Unraid and see how that's been implemented. So if I go under device here and take a look at my ZFS pool, I can see all of my drives here, and then I can click scrub to manually scrub it, and it looks like it should start saying that it's scrubbing right now. So it says the speed that it's scrubbing and all of that information. I can also set it to automatically scrub it every hour, for example, and it should run a scrub job every hour on the system. Now I want to take a look at what happens if a scrub fails and see if Unraid's very good at reporting the scrub failure. So I'm going to actually purposely corrupt some data on the drive to make it so the scrub fails on purpose and see how well Unraid supports listing that out to the user. So now I've used DD to write some data to the disk that intentionally caused data errors. So if I take a look at the ZFS scrub result, I see that there's data errors on the disk and it says that there's been data corrupted. So applications may be affected, but if I take a look at the alerts and notifications and look at their history and then remove all of the filters, I don't see anything. I see a lot of disk issues, which I do know about because of these drives, but other than that, disk overheated, uncorrectable errors, let me know if you see anything looking through this list, but I don't see anything telling me about ZFS. And if I go to dashboard here, it looks all fine according to this system. It says everything looks fine, and it doesn't seem to report any issues in ZFS Pool C. Another thing I noticed when taking a look at the dashboard on this system was the amount of ZFS memory, which I'm guessing is the amount of memory that the Arc is using in ZFS, because ZFS has its own way of doing read and write caching of disks that's different than the standard Linux system. If I wanted to find out how large the ZFS Arc or RAM cache is, I could run something like arc underscore summary, but I get an error that Python 3 is not installed. And because Unraid is kind of a read-only operating system, I can't just go install Python 3. And other tools like arcstat doesn't have it either. It needs Python 3. So I can go to sys module zfs-parameter to take a look at the actual data that typically these Python scripts are going to be pulling from. So I can run something like cat zfs underscore arc underscore maybe max is typically that. And it looks like that's about 6 gigabytes of data. I'm curious how Unraid is trying to decide that 6 gigabytes is a reasonable amount of arc memory for the system. So one way to figure out if it's a tied percentage to the amount of system memory is to take out some system memory and see if it goes down. So I'm going to take out 2/3 of my system memory and see if that number goes down. And now my system is started up again with 16 gigabytes of RAM. Taking a look, ZFS has 0% of RAM in the Arc, which makes sense because ZFS hasn't loaded any pools. And if I take a look at that same directory to find out what the maximum amount of Arc size is currently, it's about 2 gigabytes, which is about 1/8 of my 16 gigabytes of RAM, which seems like it's setting the Arc size to about 1/8 of the total system memory. And I don't see a GUI to configure ZFS settings anywhere else in Unraid, so I can't find a way to configure anything else. From what I've seen today, Unraid in ZFS is a little bit half-baked and still has a ways to go before it's fully ready to be used. And hopefully they do this work before the final release comes out, and these are just some beta teething issues, but I'll have to find out when that final release actually comes out. I think a good amount of the issues I've seen with ZFS revolves around trying to use how they deal with their parity array with ZFS. So for example, for ZFS, I think they should rely a lot more on reading data from the ZFS system and asking ZFS what drives are in the array, rather than trying to say these drives go into a ZFS array and don't touch it because otherwise it breaks. I'd also like to see options in the GUI for setting other ZFS features, so for perhaps setting a shift when a ZFS pool is created, or setting different levels of compression other than off and on. Hopefully, in later releases of Unraid, ZFS is supported better, so that a user can pick if they want to use ZFS or the normal Unraid array depending on what drives and what they value to have in a storage subsystem. ZFS has better speed because it can read and write from multiple drives at the same time and supports read caching better, but Unraid's main array supports using drives of mixed sizes, adding drives later on, and having a write cache so your main drives can be spun down most of the time. And I think it's nice to have more options in an operating system, and Unraid adding features will make it a better OS. Let me know what your thoughts on adding ZFS in Unraid is, and if you've used the plugins before and how that's worked out for you.